everyone. Welcome to Deep Techno Elite. I am Deep Malavakode. In the last session, we have learned constant and magic constant in PHP. Also, we have learned about the functions in PHP. In this session, I am going to show you how to write decision-making code using if-else-else-if statement in PHP. So, let's get started with subscribing the channel and hit the bell so you don't miss anything. There are several statements in PHP that you can use to make decision based on the different conditions. They are if statement, if-else statement, if-else-if-else statement, and switch case statement. We will explore each of these statements one by one. So, let's start the Visual Studio Code and don't forget to start your XAMPP server. And now, let's create a file and call it as statement.php. Press enter. Basically, the idea behind the if-else statement is that we can write code that perform a different actions based on the result of a logical or comparative test conditions at runtime. So, let's see the syntax for if statement. We have an if keyword followed by the conditional expression, opening and closing curly bracket, and inside the curly bracket, the code to be executed. If condition is true, let's see the simple example of if statement. In if statement, output will appear only when the condition is true. If condition is false, it displays nothing. Let's have a look at the example. Let's have a PHP tag here. Now let's declare a variable having a value say 10, and now let's have a if statement. If followed by a condition $num is less than 100, opening and closing curly bracket, and now let's echo $num is less than 100, end with the semicolon. If the condition is true, it will display the value of the variable $num is less than 100. So, let's see the output. Go to the browser and type here localhost colon 8080 slash tutorial slash and change the file name statement.php. Press enter and it will display 10 is less than 100, and if I change the value of $num, let's say 101, save this and refresh the browser, and it will display nothing. And now let's see the if-else statement. If-else statement is slightly different from if statement. If-else statement is executed whether condition is true or false. That means it executes one block of code if the specified condition is true and another block of code if the condition is false. So, let's see the syntax for if-else statement. If followed by a conditional expression, opening and closing curly brace, and code to be executed if condition is true. After the closing of curly bracket, here we have a else keyword and opening and closing curly bracket. Inside the opening and closing curly bracket, the code to be executed if the condition is false. So, let's have an example for if-else statement. Let's have a else keyword here, opening and closing curly bracket. And now let's have a echo, $num is greater than 100. End with the semicolon. Here we have a variable with a value 101 and a if condition, that is the $num variable is less than 100. If this condition is true, it will display the value of the variable is less than 100, or if the condition is false, it will execute this else block that the value of $num is greater than 100. So let's save this and refresh the browser. And it will display 101 is greater than 100. The if statement checks both the conditions and execute the block of code which specific condition is true. Next we have if-elseif-else statement. The if-elseif-else statement executes code for more than two conditions, so we can check multiple conditions using this statement. It can be written like this: if followed by condition 1, opening and closing curly bracket, code to be executed if the condition 1 is true, else if followed by a condition 2, opening and closing curly bracket, and inside the curly bracket, code to be executed if the condition 2 is true, else opening and closing curly bracket, and code to be executed if both condition 1 and condition 2 are false. So let's have an example. Let's declare a variable $num1 equals to 10, end with the semicolon, and now let's declare another variable $num2 equals to 20, semicolon. Let's have a if statement: $num1 is not equals to $num2, opening and closing curly bracket, echo $num1 is not equal to $num2, and now let's have a break, echo break. After the closing curly brace, let's have else if condition $num1 is greater than $num2, opening and closing curly bracket, let's echo $num1 is greater than $num2, let's echo break. End with the semicolon. Let's have one more else if statement followed by a condition $num1 is less than $num2, opening and closing curly bracket, and now let's echo $num1 is less than $num2, end with the semicolon, and now let's echo break. And now let's have else, opening and closing curly brace, echo $num1 is equals to $num2. Save this and let's have a look at the output. And it will display 10 is not equals to 20. The if-elseif-else statement check the multiple conditions and it will execute the block of code for the true condition. Now let's move on to switch case statement in PHP. We have learned how if-elseif-else statement works. Now we are going to get familiar with the PHP switch case statement. They both are conditional statement. The switch case statement is quite simple. It evaluates the expression or variable once and then it compares the value to one of the given cases. If no match is found, then the default case is executed. We use break after every block of code to prevent code from continuing. So let's see the syntax for switch case statement. Let's have a break here and here also. Save this. We have a switch keyword followed by an expression, opening and closing curly bracket. Then we have case value 1 followed by a colon, and after that a code to execute if expression equals to value 1. Then we have break semicolon, then case value 2 followed by a colon, and then we have code to be executed if expression is equals to value 2. Then we have a break. Then we have default keyword colon, and code to be executed if expression is not equal to any value. So let's have a look at the example. Let's declare a variable $number, let's say 1, semicolon, then I'm going to write switch followed by an expression $number, opening and closing curly bracket, let's have case 0, colon, and now let's echo number is equal to 0, semicolon, let's have a break, end with the semicolon, and then I'm going to have case 1, colon, echo, number is equal to 1, end with the semicolon, let's have break, case 2, colon, echo, number is equal to 2, end with the semicolon, let's have break, and now I'm going to have default keyword followed by a colon, and now let's have echo invalid number . Save this and let's have a look at the output, and it will display number is equal to 1. The switch expression is evaluated once the value of expression is compared with the value of each case. If there is a match, the associated block of code is executed. Otherwise, the default block is executed, and break statement stops the execution of other case when one case match with our condition. Switch case statement supports strings also. Well, that's all for today's session. In the next session, we will see some more interesting things in PHP. To learn more, subscribe the channel and hit the bell to receive the notification. If you enjoy the video, hit the like and comment below. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon.